Back in the early 90s, we were assessing the different open protocols that existed at the time when BACnet was being produced. We were there in the beginning and were integral in the development of the BACnet testing laboratories. I've been working at Delta now for 20 years. For the last 16 of those, I've been working on the BACnet committee. It's great to work with others in the industry, working collaboratively to make BACnet better and to be able to work with these people who come at problems from different angles. At Delta, we take BACnet to heart. Many companies only provide you a gateway solution. Some only provide a high-end, high-level building controller solution. At Delta, we do BACnet top to bottom. We were the first company to come out with a full BACnet solution from the building controller all the way down to the thermostat. I really enjoy working at Delta. We have a large research and development department. We're able to be very creative. Delta was the first to come out with a high-speed data network for building automation and control. Another one of the great products that Delta produces is the IntelliTouch. When it came out, there were no other solutions like it on the market. Even today, it continues to be one of our hottest sellers. In 2010, we started Coppertree Analytics, just as the energy management market was starting to move. We've added fault detection and the energy management screen because we understand the needs of our customers.
Delta Controls has historically invested a fair amount into its product development and research and development over the years. It is the largest investment in the company as a department. There's over 200 years of experience in the product development department. I've been here over 20 years now. Actually, today is my anniversary date. Our customers are really playing an important part in our development process, and it's really helping us shape the future of our product, understanding what their real needs are for their market. Well, there's different ways that we go about collecting that information. I think one of the key points is putting the teams into the field, actually having them assisting the partners. So when they come back from the field, it's pretty specific and focused as to what improvements need to be made and which ones are the most important. We responded to a problem in the Middle East just a few weeks ago and had something resolved for them within that, I think it was just over the weekend.
When product is shipped, it then becomes our responsibility to make sure that our partners are supported. Once a problem hits us in this department, we don't let it go until it's solved. We're more than a help center. That's an important part of what we do, but we do more than that. We offer our team as an extension of our customers' engineering team. We're a global company, and as a result, we have global coverage. We cover 20 of the 24 hours of the day. We really like to see how our products are used, and we like to be part of finding new solutions that our products can be applied to. We want to get to the bottom of it, and we don't want to give up on it until we're there. So if that means we need to stay late, if that means we need to go to site to dig into the issue and collect our own information, we'll do that.